I heard you never tasted bean pie.
I'm a Muslim American. I'm ready to have some real Muslim American food.
Okay.
Let's try it out.
This is exciting. I just tasted the only legitimate Muslim American food, bean pie. I'm at this spot called Abu's Bakery, the last bakery in New York City to make it. I've since learned that this pie made from navy beans helps tell one of the most essential stories about Muslims in America. And it's delicious. My name is Ayman Ismail. To grow up Muslim means to grow up being feared. So I'm traveling the country to find out for myself if there's really any reason to be afraid of American Muslims. It sounds like I'm putting an awful lot of emphasis into a dessert, right? But to understand why, you have to go back to the 1930s. To Black American Muslims, the bean pie is a window into something much more significant. In this bakery, a 90-year legacy is being preserved. But how does this manifest into a pie? I went to the Brooklyn Historical Society to find out.
You know, people say like something is as American as apple pie. Well, I feel like it's like as Muslim American as bean pie.
Zahir Ali is an oral historian at the BHS and is currently in the process of trying to preserve Islamic American history in Brooklyn. He's also likely the bean pie's biggest fan.
I'm constantly being asked, as a Muslim, grew up in America, what is Muslim food? And I was always like, well, I don't really know if there is a Muslim food.
What I like about the bean pie is it is the only American Muslim food to be created. It came out of a Muslim community.
So how?
Part of the Nation of Islam's objective was to create a cultural identity that was independent of the legacy of slavery. So anything that could connect to what was quote unquote called a slave diet was regarded as something that should not be eaten. The bean pie was made to replace the sweet potato pie. Just like people got an X in their name to signify a break from a slave name, they also broke away from what was called a slave diet. So this pie would have been impossible without the advent of Islam in the African American community. It doesn't just come from African Americans. It comes from African American Muslims, specifically responding to their identity as Muslims. The bean pie is Islam in America. It is the quintessential Muslim American dish.
Every time I've gone to any mosque,
yes,
anywhere I go, yes, anywhere in the world, every time there's food being served, I can guarantee there's gonna be some kebab.
Yeah.
There's gonna be hummus.
Yes.
There's gonna be some tabbouleh, you know, all these.
Chicken tikka.
Yeah.
Samosas.
Yeah.
You know, like all like Eastern food, which is fine. But if they don't have bean pie, they are lacking in their Muslim food cred.
They're missing the only dish that's actually Muslim.
Exactly, they are.
Wa alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Yes, sir.
Over the years, the Nation of Islam developed the bean pie recipe, selling them on street corners to raise funds. They're shouted out in rap songs.
And I might start slinging bean pie.
TV shows.
And a bean pie fresh from the corner.
Bean pie, my brother.
And stand-up comedy routines.
Bean pie, my brother.
I told Zahir I was planning on trying the bean pie for the first time after Friday prayer. He didn't need much convincing to come along. He ordered a handful of bean pies for himself, too. At Abu's Bakery in Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn, Idris Conroy, who developed his own recipe, is like a neighborhood celebrity. After the prayer, he served half the congregation bean pie.
There was a point where no one else was selling the bean pie except the Nation of Islam. They had the recipe, and until this day, the recipe is a well-kept secret. You Google the bean pie recipe, you may not come up with anything. And if you do come up with something, it might be Martha Stewart's recipe. And she don't know how to make a bean pie.
This place holds a special significance for Black Muslims in Brooklyn. In the late 1980s, these Muslims were hailed around the world for shutting down crack houses. They cleaned up the block.
We decided we were going to shut all the drug dealers out. We didn't confront the drug dealers. We confronted the people who were coming to buy. Everything you see happening on this block today is a result of those drug patrols.
Idris no longer operates the business, but his son, also named Idris, is determined to uphold the legacy and keep the business in the family. He met me at the bakery to talk bean pie.
You know, it sounds weird because we're talking about a pie and, you know, you don't want to like, it's like, this is dessert. But if when you really think about it, which, a bean pie producer would tend to do so, you can really begin to appreciate what the product is. It's serious, you know.
So how would you react if the bean pie became a New York City staple or suddenly an American staple? And it wasn't specific to the African-American experience anymore.
It was funny, there was an episode of Chopped and they pulled a bean pie out the basket. And I was like, hey, hold up here. And he kind of gave a bad definition of the product. But that was a hint to me that maybe this is, you know, it's not, it won't be long now.
How long until somebody throws pumpkin spice in there?
You know? Right. Well, hopefully you don't have to do it like that. I mean,
the bean pie is a reminder that up until recently, the majority of Muslims in America were Black American. One researcher estimated that in 1980, they made up about 70% of Muslims here, and they're still about 20% today. While many pundits and politicians are busy trying to warn of Islam being a foreign threat, they're ignoring that Islam was in the United States before the country was even born, and many of those Muslims were brought here against their will. The bean pie is part of that story.
So I was wondering whether or not you think bean pie would be an appropriate ambassador to the Muslim American, African American experience.
African American Muslims have been, you know, for a while, the face of Islam. Initially, we have like the Malcolm X types and the whole world embraced Muhammad Ali. And it's just recently, I think, that there's been a sort of paradigm shift as Muslim is the other. The bean pie does have the potential to refocus some of this attention on the fact that Muslims have been here contributing to what it is to be America for a long time.
That reminded me of what Zahir said back at the Brooklyn Historical Society. His current project, Muslims in Brooklyn, hopes to preserve the history and legacy of Muslims here. He's interviewing prominent Muslim American voices whose lives shaped and were shaped by Brooklyn. To him, preserving the story of a simple pie is also a way of preserving the Americanness of Islam.
My parents came to this country in the 70s,
right,
like a lot of other Muslims.
Right.
But this is a whole different lineage,
yeah,
when compared, yeah, to the Black Muslim experience in America.
It challenges people's stereotypes of who Muslims are and how long they've been here and what they've done. Now, mind you, the so-called immigrant Muslims have been here for many generations too. So I don't think we should feel like we have to go to Black Muslims to prove how quote-unquote American Muslims are. We're 100 years into that process.
Growing up a first-generation American Muslim, I internalized stereotypes that Islam was foreign and that I was too. That's because Islam's long history in America is often ignored, and that's what makes Zahir's work and the legacy Idris and his father were working to preserve so important. My parents came to New York as immigrants, but it's comforting to know that Black Muslims had already paved the way for us. Their traditions are proof that the foundations of the faith have been in the country since the beginning. Through tasting the bean pie, I felt pride, specifically as an American Muslim, an identity that's been questioned or entirely denied. As long as the bean pie has a home here, so do I.